happen.
It will happen, yes. I can't wait long enough. I'm sitting like on the needles because now really it will start the real fight, you know, for perfection. I would like to be striking that all the admirers of Freddie Mercury will see him in it. And I have already in mind how to do it. And I can't tell you how much I'm really looking forward to it. There will be no more holidays, I think, now starting, if already the place is found. I hope that the place will be secure, that somebody will not try to steal a little bit of it or whole statue. Because I was in Père Lachaise and I know what happened to Jim Morrison and the surroundings. The fascination is really his strong performances, and I think he was lucky he had very beautiful songs. Few of them really I adore. I like Who Won't Live Forever. Yes, this I like very much. This is a gorgeous song for me.
There's no chance for us. It's all decided for us.
I think it's the symbol also for this tragedy with AIDS. And I think that you need to be aware of it. And as more these people are, these famous people are victims, so as more you feel that something simply must be done. We need the symbols to be aware of it, really, and it's always touching, you know. It's a tragedy for people who really live normal life. I mean, whatever, if they are heterosexual or if they are gay, but it's a normal life for them. So this punishment or whatever it is, it's not punishment, it's a tragedy, it's not fair. The main thing is a monument to Freddie Mercury as a performer. And he had appeal, big appeal to I think all sort of people, you know, because when I show it to my friends, which are even older as I am, so they were quite surprised on his, never would dream to watch this video when they saw it, so they were quite completely taken. Yes, because it was like modern ballet. He was marvelous. Yeah. I don't think that he can be replaced, really.
This superb statue is a gift from us, the family and friends of Freddie, to the people of Montreux, who have always been so kind to Queen and gave Freddie a kind of sanctuary in the last few years of his life. We say a very sincere thank you to Monsieur le Syndic and the Commune de Montreux for giving us this wonderful location. A big thank you also, merci beaucoup, to Irena Sedletska for this wonderful sculpture.
It's winter fall, red skies are gleaming. Oh, seagulls are flying over, swans are floating by, smoking chimney tops. Am I dreaming? Am I dreaming? The night's drawing. There's a silky moon up in the sky. Yeah! Children are fantasizing. Grown-ups are standing by.
We actually tried London, but although the fans were very keen on the idea, the authorities were not. So we eventually gave up the idea of having it in London because we couldn't find a suitable site. Montreux is very close to the heart of the band, really, particularly Freddie, because the last few years of his life were mostly spent here. And it was a very peaceful place for Freddie because he wasn't pursued by the press like he was in England. And so a lot of his final days, his final writing, his final singing were all done here. So it's a logical place to have the statue, and it's a beautiful site, you know, and very close to where Freddie used to live in a house on the lake when he was here, and, you know, have the view over the lake. So he now has this view forever. It's very fitting. Whoa, 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 whoa.
In the air.